Yo, what is up, my viewers? Welcome to another Ramblin video where I, your host, Gildem Warrior, comes back to ramble on about my thoughts and what have you, and we got some Pikmin play in the background. But I digress, because if you don't know how these work, the gameplay is basically, you know, second to the commentary, sort of. I don't know. To me, it's a very therapeutic process where I kind of talk and discuss my thoughts, and you, the viewers, kind of act as my therapist, and, you know, you can leave your advice in the comments or something. I don't know. I guess it's not really all that important. What's important is this part might be super random. Anything could happen. I might have a guest crash this whole entire part, but, you know, I'm looking forward to that, you know, and I'm not being like, oh, my friend's gonna crash the part. No, it's like, it's an exciting thing, because it's like, you never know what's gonna happen. Oh, man. Maybe I put my gain too high. I don't know. I always find that I always have to edit my voice a little bit up, because it's just a little too soft. But then at the same time, you know, I start getting really loud and obnoxious, and then it's like, oh, now it's too loud. Too loud. Anyways, I digress, because that's why I'm saying a lot in this part. What is important is that tonight's going to be a fun night, and I have a lot of other things to talk about, because I have some issues that are plaguing me, plaguing my mind. And so, it won't just be about me being an introvert this time. Because I'm sick and tired of, like, complaining about being an introvert. I mean, I get it. You guys get it. It was fine the first time. Now it's just like, God damn it, Gildem. Talk about something else. And it's like, okay, all right. I got something to talk about. YouTube. Or, not YouTube. YouTube's fine. I have no issues with YouTube. My editing software. Yeah, there we go. So, what I wanted to discuss is, I've been trying to get, like, silky smooth footage, you know, the type that you see professionals have on their channel, and it's, like, super awesome and amazing, and it's like, oh, man, all I want to do is just have professional-level, gameplay where it's, like, super smooth, it looks super live, and it looks like you guys are playing alongside with me, or at the very least watching it happen at the same time as me talking about whatever I have going on, where I'm going with the commentary. Who knows? It's not really important. But the thing about it is, I found out my capture software is really good. Like, it can do 60 frames per second. You know, that's pro. That's like ideal. That's the level of stuff that I want. On the other hand, I go to my editing software, and it's like, every time it has to render a video, you know, I do the fun little edits and whatnot, the really stupid, frivolous stuff. Alphaflame challenges me a lot to that, you know. But apparently when I render the video, it cuts it down to 30 frames per second, so it cuts in half. It's not like that's terrible, you know, but it's not ideal for me, because it's like, man, it doesn't look as silky smooth. It looks alright. For newer games, I think it's really hard to tell, or it's harder to tell. But, like, say I want to go with my old school, like, NES stuff, or, like, Super Nintendo, or what have you, because, you know, I'm all about the retro gaming. I find it's a lot more noticeable then. And it's like, this isn't okay, man. All I want to do is have the professional level quality stuff. And it's like, I was looking up some stuff because, you know, it's the internet. It's like, you know, 2017 or something. I don't know, maybe later, depending on when you're watching this, because I have no control over that. You guys can listen to me complain about my thoughts, my ideas, and everything. Whatever, it doesn't matter. I guess I'm just getting off topic like I usually do. My point is, all I want to do is have really nice videos, professional level quality. Can't have that when, you know, like, everything's not in line. And all I want is everything in line, you know. All I want to do is produce really nice, high level quality, silky smooth gameplay footage. You know, I want to capture the footage, and then I just want to, like, you know, do my edits. Because I do that occasionally. Sometimes I had to edit the volume, you know. I find actually separating the audio my commentary, in other words, and the video, which I guess is also the audio of the gameplay and whatnot, but, you know, I like to have those two things separate, because my capture software, I can do those together, but once it's all captured together, then it's like, well, if I goof up in the recording, it's like, it's a one-shot take, there's no going back. But if I do the audio separate, you know, it's like, it doesn't matter. All I have to do is just edit out the parts that I don't like. And sometimes I do that, you know, sometimes I goof up, I make mistakes, and it's not good for everybody. You know, sometimes, you know, I run out of air, because that happens at times. I get long-winded, and then all of a sudden I can't breathe. And my throat gets all clogged up, and then I have to, like, cough to clear it out. It happens. It does. I don't know. I guess what I'm saying is, you know, sometimes I do, like, bodily function things, and it's like I can't edit that stuff out if it's one take. Sometimes I want to. Sometimes I'm hacking my lungs out because I'm still sort of sick. And, you know, sometimes I don't want to deafen you guys more than I have to. Now, commentary is key. Everything else, not so much, I guess. Also, you know, having some sort of fluid helps break the monotony, I find. Also, when you're drinking, like I usually do in my Mega Man parts, you know, it's like, hey, it helps to continue the vibe of everything, because, you know, that's really good. Speaking of which, I just recorded some. In fact, at the time of this, one of those is already up right now. And by the time this is produced, which should be tomorrow, yeah, guys, it will be on my channel. One of them. I don't know. I'm trying to avoid dating this as much as possible, even though I said Mega Man, because, you know, who knows? Maybe in 5 years it's going to be like Mega Man X, or maybe it's going to be like something else. I probably gave you a hint that it's the regular Mega Man, not Mega Man X. I've never played Mega Man X, to be honest. Not yet, at least. I haven't decided if I'm going to move on to doing Mega Man X after Mega Man, if I get that far. Because, you know, right now it's just kind of the challenge of doing Mega Man drunk. Which I have no idea why I decided to do that, but, you know, Chaz is on board, I'm on board, it's just a thing that's going on, and I'm happy with it. And, you know, I always enjoy challenging myself. It's kind of a random challenge, you know, doing an old school NES game while you're completely out of your mind intoxicated. But I have fun. I enjoy it. I think it's fun. Anyways, I don't know how I got off topic from ranting to just, like, talking about why I enjoy doing old school NES games drunk. It's just what I do. It's just what I enjoy. It's fun. That said, I don't like doing it all the time. I mean, come on. Some of you guys might think, Gildem, you have a drinking problem. But no, it's not that. It's not. That's not it. I record, like, the whole game in one sitting with Chaz, and then I don't drink. In fact, I'm not really all that prone to drinking a whole lot. Because, you know, it's like, as fun as it is getting drunk as an adult, because I'm not trying to suggest underage drinking here. I mean, come on, that's stupid. I don't want to be responsible for that. I mean, come on. That would be the stupidest thing ever. I mean, I'd be a bad role model. Gildem, you're not a good role model. You never were. Gah. Anyways, but all I'm saying is, like, you know, things that you can do as an adult. For instance, substance. Not substance abuse, just substances, like alcohol. You know, it's kind of fun. It's not fun all the time. Believe me. When you drink to the point where you throw up, oh, it's painful. Of course, I shrugged that off like no problem. I haven't thrown up in a while from drinking, which is great. I think my body's finally adjusted to the whole alcohol abuse. Or maybe the better result, I've actually found out my good medium, where it's like, I don't drink too much, but I drink just enough, where, like, I have that good buzz going, and that's really ideal, especially where you need to be, you know, because I don't want to get too drunk. It's a bad time. Also, dairy, another bad time. It gives you, it curls in your stomach. You give massive, abdominal cramps. Overall, it's just not a fun experience. Not at all. I don't recommend it. You guys, all I'm saying is, you know, drink responsibly. Like they say in all the commercials, you know, it's like, you gotta be very careful. Otherwise, you really get into some massive trouble. And by the way, if you drink too much, you black out, and then you don't remember anything, and that's when the real regret starts happening. Chaz has been there. I don't know how he managed to handle it. I don't know how he manages to handle me being drunk. I think to some degree, I am pretty entertaining. I mean, that's what I hear all the time, like, especially, like, when I'm with my friends, and they're just like, yo, let's start drinking, and it's like, okay, whatever. As long as I don't have to drive, I mean, I'm fine with it. Because that's the thing. If you're going to drink, play it smart, you know. Make sure you don't have to drive. I try to make sure I go along those lines. Because I'm really hesitant about anything when it comes to me having to be in control of anything. I don't like it. Not one bit. It's just not a fun situation. I mean, for one, having to focus is a terrible thing, especially when you're drunk. On the other hand, the reason why I'm able to play Mega Man and games like that is because I practice enough that I know what to do. I got it down. Anyways, I gotta cut the recording here very momentarily. It's gonna be a second for you guys, but I got something in the oven and I gotta go take it out. Or check on it. I don't really know. Interruptions! Alright, you know, it's like things like that where I have to cut it for a second. And I can do fun little edits. Like that. I know. It might not make a whole lot of sense because literally I'm just resuming the part where I left off. But, I mean, I was thinking about this, I might as well just put one in, because if I just resume, it's going to seem really random, just to, like, cut my commentary. I have to separate audio from commentary, because gameplay audio, which I guess is probably the most minor part of this whole entire thing, but I feel like it'd be good for everybody, everyone involved. Oh man, I got a guest, he's coming up, you know him, you love him.
What's up?
It's Spider Mikey.
Oh man, it's good to see you.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
Yeah. Oh, like I said in the beginning, I might have a random guest just showing up.
Yeah, yeah, man,
yeah.
It's me.
So I guess this is officially group therapy, although fuck it, I'm still calling it Rambling number 4.
Nice.
So yeah, I got a guest. I couldn't have timed that any better. Because yeah. I like spontaneous random events. You never know what's gonna happen. Oh,
so what the hell are we playing over here?
Oh, it's Pikmin. It's just my rambling video. I was telling you about this the other day, where it's just me.
I don't remember what game it was, though.
Oh, it doesn't matter. You know what? This is... So, if you don't know how this works, basically, I have gameplay footage for the viewers.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm just talking about my thoughts. This is therapy in a nutshell.
Yeah.
Wrapped up into about 30 minutes or something.
I could use some therapy.
Yeah. Anyways, so something had to happen to me, because I had to cut it. I had to go check on the oven, because I had, like, food cooking.
Oh, good. I'm so hungry.
Yeah. So that's out of the oven. But while I was checking it, I found out I had a comment on one of my videos.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, sweet. Except, I don't know if this happens to you a lot, but on my channel, because I produce so much stuff per day and I plan that, and I'm actually on the schedule now, I get random comments from other YouTubers, usually, like, guys that are trying to make it big, you know, they're probably streaming, and so they got their highlights on their YouTube channel, and they'll always find, like, small channels like myself, and go like, hey, cool video, bro, if you guys would second, can you check out my channel, hyperlink, yeah, have a good day. And, like, I don't know, this guy from, I want to say, like, from Europe.
Wow.
I want to say, like, England, or, I don't know. I want to say England.
You check the channel.
Yeah, I don't know, it doesn't matter. Point is, like, I don't mind that so much, because I understand when people are, like, trying to, like, get started, you know, they got to get more views, so they kind of have to, like, whore out a little bit. Not that I'm saying they're whores, I'm just saying that, like, they gotta do that in order to get the attention. I get that, you know? Best of luck. I will support those people.
You almost gotta think, though, if they're doing it on one of your random videos, like, how many times they spam this to everybody?
Okay, I was getting to that. That was my next point. So, going back to it, then this one guy, he just started doing that to, like, three or four of my videos,
Oh my God.
Like, if you do it once, I will support you. Yeah. You do it, like, more than two times, I will unsubscribe to you, because I will subscribe to you just to help you out, just to, like, get those numbers up, because, as we all know, bigger numbers is better. But you do it more than, like, two times, because I will give you the benefit of the doubt on the second time. Just, like, you know, maybe it's just a coincidence, you probably don't know, you're probably not even paying attention while you're leaving these comments. Mm-hmm. But you do it more than twice, I'm not supporting you anymore. Clearly, you're just finding like the nearest channel that has produced stuff within the hour, which is probably what happened with this guy. It's just like on like the gaming part of YouTube.
It's probably a bot.
No, honestly. it's like legit.
Is it different comments each time?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's a different channel.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, like the only reason I bring up this one guy is because like his, like. The guy, his own channel, he was doing that, and it's so easy. All you gotta do is, like, write, like, the thing, and then just, like, leave the name blank, and then, like, find the channel, copy-paste the name, and then, you know, post that shit. I was thinking about doing that for my channel, but then I was like, I don't want to do that. I'm so low-key, it doesn't really matter.
Just do it on a really large streamer. Maybe you'll get, like, 500.
I doubt it. Anyways, so, you have anything you want to share?
I'm sure I will throughout, but right the second, I got nothing.
Okay, alright, so I guess
I just bought a printer that looks just like that.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've had that for a while.
I was gonna go buy ink, but ink was like $40, so I was like, fuck that. Why buy ink when I could buy a brand new printer? It makes no goddamn sense.
I mean, like, that, yeah, no, I've had that for a while. I got it for college back in the day.
Yeah, so did I, mine.
I mean, it's nice to print stuff out. It has Wi-Fi, so basically, my grandparents, with their computer downstairs, they can choose whatever they want. Like, say, like, Anson, can you help us print this out? And I'll do it for them, because they don't know how to work that stuff. By the way, anyone who's like, you live with your grandparents, you're such a loser. It's like, yeah, I do. Rent's cheap.
Exactly.
Rent's cheap. In addition, I can use the excuse, they need me. They rely on me.
Exactly.
Because they actually say that every now and then. Yeah.
In a garage in the middle of nowhere.
It's nice, though.
But I'm happy.
Yeah. Like, I'm happy. I don't care if I'm a loser because
of it. Yeah, exactly.
Dude, you want to know why people live in their mom's basement when they're like 40? Because they're happy with it.
Nobody can judge me when I'm all alone in my room.
I mean, like, I said I was going to stop being an introvert, but I mean, really, it's like, you know, I think that's why introverts get along with each other. They just understand the base point where it's like, there's nothing wrong with living.
Well, I mean, we say we're not going to, and then we go outside once, and instantly decide, you know what, let's go back inside.
Well, especially with today, it's raining.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, granted, everyone's going to say, what, Washington State rains? No shit!
So I posted on Facebook, you know, this weather.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
You know why I did that?
Why?
So I took the back roads to my house.
Oh god.
Because, you know, lesser than two hills.
Yeah.
I got stuck in the middle of the hill.
Oh.
My truck would not move, so it was either go down or, like, somehow back up into some weird road.
Right.
I literally got stuck in the middle of two hills. I had to park and call my grandparents to pick me up.
Oh no.
Through the ice.
I should probably give a little context. So recently, the recording of this, we had like this massive snowstorm. Mm-hmm. It was short-lived. Literally, like, within, I want to say, like, within a day, like, it all melted, but...
Not next to my house.
His house is a little weird.
Within the day,
His house is a little weird, like, it sticks there, even though, like, I was relatively in the same area, but, like, I saw it as it started, because I was at work, I was just waiting, I got there, not a flake in sight, then within 10 minutes, just, like, wind and snow, just out of everywhere, it was snowing with fury! And I was like, just telling everyone, this is bullshit. And no one's like, what the hell are you talking about? It doesn't make any sense. Like, and it's like, you're not gonna get stuck. And it's like, no, we got, this is fucking bullshit. Because I don't want to drive in this shit. Because it's annoying. Like, rain, I get that. It's not a problem. You can just
do that. Snow is just really annoying because it's like it stays there, mm-hmm. and it was sticking to the roads, and I was like, this is, what the fuck is this shit?
Well, the word, like, driving in the snow is okay.
Yeah.
But then, like, in the morning when I went somewhere and I was coming back, mm-hmm. then it started, like, hailing, and it started, like, you know, the sleet.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
So the roads were just, like, you know, like, yeah. slushy.
I was asleep while that happened, apparently, because, so, like, the snowstorm that I'm talking about, it happened while I was at work, which was about, like, I want to say, like, 10 at night. Because I work nights. For you viewers, that's context. But, like, during the day, it was, like, hell and sleet. Mm-hmm. And my grandparents saw that, and they're like, it was doing it with fury, and it was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, it was bad.
Yeah. So, I missed out on that. But apparently that's what happened. The weather was really random.
Mm-hmm. Got stuck in the middle of the hill.
And now it's just been raining.
Yeah.
And that's all it's been doing for the past couple of days. Mm. Anyways, so if you guys can't tell, we're gonna have some fun tonight. That's the idea. But again, rambling video, so I'm keeping it really chill. Don't worry, it's almost over. Well, this is all pre-recorded.
Yeah,
I don't really care.
I'm sure I got tons of shit.
Yeah, I know.
I actually got a funny story about my ex.
Oh, dude, you want to share?
Oh, sure. I mean, it's kind of random.
Within, like, 10 seconds.
So she's, like, trying to become a model, right?
Right.
So I've been kind of stalking her and stuff. I've been waiting for it. Finally got a nude shot. I mean, there's tape on the nipples.
Well, fair enough. I mean, it doesn't leave much to the imagination.
There it is. Yeah. Struggling model, of course.
Hey, don't you dare shame him. I mean, we all do it, you know?
The boobs are a lot smaller than I was doing.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I mean, hey... I mean, it's I like I was telling.
I think she's like 95 pounds. She's like, this is disgusting.
Okay, I was just gonna say. I mean, like, it's like I was telling my coworker the other day. You know, big booty bitches. Mm-hmm. And he's like, there's nothing wrong with big booty bitches. And he's like, bro. Unless the booty's too big,
yeah,
it's like I can't handle that shit. I was like, heresy. It's never too big, because as we all know, the bigger it is, it's just more cushion for the pushing. Boobs, on the other hand, they sag eventually.
So it gets to the point where, like, you gotta fight to get in there.
Yeah, that's just a challenge.
Well, I mean, when I'm, you know, doing the deed, I don't want a challenge, I just want to enjoy it.
I never get the deed, yeah. So it doesn't really matter.
Well,
I mean,
hypothetically, if I
Yeah. I don't know, I figure, like, the next chick I date, I want her to have a really big ass.
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
But see, that's what I like about these, I can just talk about anything, and no one's really gonna care. Mm-hmm. Unless, you know, you get the offhand chance where there's this one guy that's like, what the fuck did I stumble on?
I'm so triggered. And I'm like...
And then they just start watching the whole entire series.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, I've been wondering, because last week, I was recording with Chaz, and we ended up doing group therapy, which was this extension of this, essentially. It's just multiple people, like, here now doing that. I'm still calling this rambling because it started out that way. You just came in, like, halfway through, so it's, like, no biggie. Not even worried about it. I like having multiple people on the segment. But I'm thinking about just making, like, an additional playlist, which is just chronologically, like, all the videos from newest to oldest. Because I'm sure, like, if anyone wants to know what's current in my life or whatever, they want us to hear the newest rather than, like, you know, day one. I'm starting this new segment. I'm an introvert. Fuck it! But no, like I said, I'm trying to avoid talking about, like, too much of my introversies, because I complain about that shit all the time. I've been complaining about that for the last 3 segments. And you know what? It's gotten old. It's tired as fuck. I don't want to do that shit.
I mean, what else do we have to talk about?
Well, I mean, big booty bitches!
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, man!
That is true.
Heresy if you say it's too big.
You know, back on that, like, I've dated some big booty chicks before.
Actually, I think I remember your last one.
Yeah, but I haven't dated too many chicks with big boobs, so I'm gonna go with that next.
Big boobs?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I could call her my first girlfriend, but the first chick that I was, like, hypothetically dating, she had pretty big boobs.
Yeah, I mean, I've had big boobs, like,
yeah,
deals,
yeah,
but, you know, my past couple girlfriends have been pretty small.
the things that guys talk about.
Yeah.
I know some people are just like, why are you talking about this shit? Because I don't get any.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, seriously, I haven't gone on a date in like several years. It's really sad and depressing. And love doesn't shine on me, but you know what? I think I'll save that for next time because, you know, Valentine's Day is around the corner.
God,
yeah. And it's really depressing, especially when you're single. And you know, I get it. Everyone's like, chocolate! And you know what? I find solace in chocolate. I love chocolate. Chocolate's like the best. Mm-hmm. Whenever I meet someone who doesn't like chocolate, I get sad inside. It's like, how can you not like chocolate?
See, I'm gonna go to the store on Valentine's Day and buy a shit ton of chocolate.
Yeah.
And the cashier's gonna be like, oh, he's such a sweet boyfriend. Little does she know, I'm just gonna go home and eat all that shit by myself.
Unless, like, she's cute, and then you just, like, give her a box, and it's like, I got these for you. Okay, bye.
Yeah, that's not real.
I got it.
Like, these are for you? Like, fuck off.
What was I gonna say? There was something related. I was gonna say, yeah, some people find solace in chocolate. Some people don't, because I have an aunt, and she doesn't like chocolate or peanut butter.
Oh, man.
And I'm just like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Yeah, but, like, if I was dating a chick who didn't like chocolate or peanut butter, I wouldn't be dating that chick.
Yeah, I wouldn't either, but my uncle, it's my uncle's choice.
Yeah.
And, my uncle is a different dude. He's pretty cool. He's pretty funny. So, I guess I have to go with his judgment that he made the right choice, because he seems to be happy with my aunt, so I have nothing to say negative towards her. Although, she, like, I don't know. Like, my family is really weird when it comes to me, because, you know, being the introvert that I am, which I can't get away from, I tend to think that my family sees a lot more of that side, so, you know, they don't really see the sociable, commentary-loving guy that I am, you know, just going all off the walls, balls crazy, talking about this, that, and life itself. No, my family, for some reason, I can't really, like, talk to them.
No, I'm the same way.
Yeah, I don't know, there's just this one thing that's really difficult. And then there's, like, the other side, where it's, like, trying to drink with them. It's just really weird.
I can't.
Oh my god. Like, I know you're telling me about your brothers, it's just, like, such a weird concept, but it's, like, my mom. She's not an alcoholic, but, like, every now and then, she really enjoys, like, a good drink, and I can relate. I cannot drink with her. I've tried. I cannot. Like, my mind's just like, no. It's just, like, something, like, there's a switch, you know, there's this hypothetical switch that just flips in your mind. It's like, I can't do this.
Nah, I know exactly.
And it's the weirdest feeling in the world, because, you know, I want to drink with my mom. Like, deep down, it's like, I want to do this. But I can't. Something is just going off in the back of my head where it's like, I can't. Like, and it's not just my mom, it's like, I want to drink with my stepdad too, because he's a really cool guy. Like, you ever see Mad Max? I mean, like, with Mel Gibson, the old Mad Max? Here, the new one's really good.
Oh, it's really good.
Yeah. I just watched Thunderdome recently. My stepdad would be proud of me. He'd be so proud. But, like, my stepdad kind of looks like Mad Max, now that I think about it, like Mel,
I'd have to look at him.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, like, I think it's long hair, and just, like, the leather jacket, because he rocks that shit. Oh, and he does it well, too. Oh, dude, my stepdad's such a metalhead, but, you know what? No, it's cool, because, like, he's introduced me to, like, so many different types of, like, bands, and a lot of different types of movies. In fact, he gives me movies. He's like, watch this shit. You're gonna love it.
Awesome.
Yeah, no, like, when I say he'd be proud of me, it's because I just watched Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome recently, and that's something that he's been trying to get me to do for years, and I haven't done it, because I just haven't sat down and watched it, because I keep getting sidetracked by anything on Netflix or anything, but it's like, no, I totally should, because, like, I play The Binding of Isaac and stuff like that, and that's a really chill game that I just like having stuff on the background. That's how I watch a lot of the movies that I do watch. But I haven't done it yet, and so I finally did, and I was like, yeah, this was pretty good. Although halfway through, I kind of didn't really understand where the plot was going.
Yeah.
I have to admit that, but the action was, like, grade A, like, material, just fantastic. I had a lot of fun watching it. I'm gonna watch Gladiator next with Russell Crowe.
Oh, you haven't seen that?
I saw part of it. I was trying to watch it, but then work kind of got in the way.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah. But that's one that my stepdad actually, like, I had for so long. Because my stepdad's like, yo, go watch this.
Yeah,
it's good.
It's a must-see.
Yeah, and I was. And then eventually enough time passed that he got, like, another one. And so he just gave me Gladiator. So I got Gladiator. So I got to go watch that. But yeah, my stepdad would be so proud of me. I'm actually getting through the list. And he's given me a lot of spaghetti westerns, you know, God, I can't think of the name. Don't worry, it'll come back to me. Come back at the end of this video.
Yeah.
God, why can't... Clint Eastwood.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Because, you know, he's like the Western star guy. He's amazing. He's got that look of just like, don't fuck with me. You know what I'm talking about?
No, I know.
Yeah, yeah. You know Macaulay Culkin in, what is it, Good Son?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The line you keep saying because it's hilarious. Yeah. Clint Eastwood, he has that look.
Don't fuck with me.
Oh, but he doesn't say it, he just shows it. And it's like, no, you don't want to. But I hear a lot of good things, and I mean, like, to prove a fact, I actually dig the hell out of Red Dead Revolver. Red Dead Redemption is amazing, don't get me wrong, but, like, Red Dead Revolver is, like, I love that game, it's great. The main character is based off of Clint Eastwood and, like, all the times they use in spaghetti westerns, so it's like, ideally, I should watch those.
I haven't really seen too many of them.
Yeah, I haven't either, but, like, my stepdad, he just gave me, like, a stack of DVDs.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Ones where, like, Clint Eastwood was a star, like, Oh, I'm gonna botch the names. I probably shouldn't say them.
Yeah, probably just let it go.
Because, like, I'm gonna mix them up, and it's gonna be like, Gildem, you don't know your shit. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Like, I'll say it for you, viewers. Don't worry. But I don't know. See, this is why I need therapy, but I don't want to pay for it because I'm stingy on money. Because I have all these thoughts, and I need to ventilate them. Because otherwise, it's like putting pins in your back, just being like. Fucking, they just keep adding up.
I know,
it all
so
keeps adding up. Think
so
I've had enough. sorry, viewers. Anyways, so I think this is pretty good. I had a lot of fun. I had a special guest star come in and just like be like, yo, I'm crashing your shit.
Yeah,
and you know what? Yeah. And you know what? We gotta go get some dinner and then go make some magic happen with footage. So I'm going to end up here. Spider-Mikey, you got anything you want to say?
Later.
Later. Okay. Later.